This video is sponsored by Skylum Luminar.
Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Remember me to the one who lives there. She once was a true love of mine. Tell her to reap it with a sickle bell. Sage, rosemary, generals order their soldiers to kill.
I'm going on
and to fight for a cause they've long ago forgotten. She'll be a true love of mine. Are you going to Scarborough Fair? Sage, rosemary, and thyme. Remember me to the one who lives there. She once was a true love of
So a few months ago, I joined my family in a trip to Madeira, which is an island off the Moroccan coast that is part of the Portuguese territory. And this is a very, very magical island, very interesting things about this island. And at the time I thought how cool it would be because I was together with my brother who helped me film this video. So thank you, Daniel, so much for that. And it was very interesting that I thought, okay, I'm going to be filming this, filming the whole experience and maybe just talk about the cameras and photos and stuff like that, like I usually do on my film diaries. But I found myself thinking, obviously now, looking back then, but also within that specific setting and timing, photographing around, you know, those people that are very dear to me as well. I found myself thinking about the intention behind photography, the importance of intention, my intentions with my photography, and why I photograph, why I'm a photographer. And today we're going to be talking about these questions, and also I'm going to flip them to you because I'd like to know what your intentions are with your photography and why you're a photographer. Why do you photograph? And so this is, you know, there's a lot to talk to you about today, a lot to share. But before we go into the video, I also like to say that I've selected some images that I'm going to put up on my website as pre-orders, very limited prints that I'm going to be doing only this run. And yeah, I'm going to signing them and number them. So if you'd like to pre-order, please go ahead and do so. It would help massively the channel. And if you're interested, of course, but to me, it's very important that you're watching and, you know, your support and is already very, very good. And I am very grateful for it. And so, yes, I have a lot to share with you. I have a lot to share with you in terms of images, in terms of thoughts. So why don't you just go ahead, grab a drink, make yourself comfortable, and let's go straight to another video. To be honest with you, for this trip, I took with me so many different cameras and formats, which is very unlike me. But I suppose I was also trying to gauge what I was going to find. And also because I knew I was going to be with my family, a Polaroid seemed very appropriate to capture more intimate moments. And so I took my Polaroid now, which is a very interesting camera that in time will have its own dedicated video here on the channel. I took also my Mamiya 7, which is the medium format camera I use mostly to capture my work. And I also took my Minolta Peace, which is a 35mm panoramic film camera. And if you're curious, go watch the video I made about taking cinematic photos with that particular camera. And last but not least, my Canon A1, a 35mm replacement for my Leica, as it's currently being fixed. But I feel like this trip it's almost like I practice two different kinds of photography, a more intimate one and a more, let's say, serious/professional one, close to my work and the themes I like to capture. And to be honest, I spend my days literally cruising around the island, and either I was capturing portraits of my family and snapping away with my Polaroid and my Canon, or just focusing on more detailed and thoughtful compositions with my Mamiya 7. And I think this whole experience made me think of the reasons why I photograph. Of course, when I created my YouTube channel, I definitely wanted to make videos that would be helpful, inspiring, and focusing more on, let's say, the philosophical or artistical side of photography. But I also wanted to put myself out there as a photographer and share my work with the world. And I feel that despite knowing there's a lot to improve and grow as a photographer and creative, that's not just the sole reason why I photograph. I photograph because I have themes or ideas I want to express, things that I want to say with my photography, but I'm also a photographer because I choose to place value in given moments in life. And those can be moments that I'll share with everyone here on the channel, but they can also be very intimate and personal moments, such as some of the ones I've captured in the Polaroids here, or for instance, my own self-portraits, which I shared in a video a little while ago. And I think it's really interesting, you know, to obviously sit down and make videos about my photography and my path and my discoveries and, you know, the ins and outs of my photography. But I also feel that, you know, now sitting here, it's very important to just talk about or even think about the reasons why I photograph. And sometimes this can, you know, serve as a compass as to, you know, when I feel lost, which is not the case here. I just sort of probably am very introspective now and just thinking out loud. But, you know, it can be obviously a question of intention and looking back at why, you know, why I started, for instance, like kind of looking myself to uplift myself and the sort of motivation. But it can be for many reasons that I do this. And I wanted to pass this challenge to you, and I wanted you to sort of sit down with yourself and ask yourself, why do you photograph? Why are you a photographer? And write down below, because obviously I'll be answering you all, and it'll be interesting to create a sort of dialogue between me and you and all of you in the comment section as to why we photograph and why it's so important that we do it. And I think that looking back at some of the reasons why I photograph, which I've stated a few, but I have a couple more that I could say up my sleeve that I could say there are very valid reasons why I photograph. And I feel like I also photograph because I appreciate the beauty of the everyday life. No matter what camera I have in my hands, and sometimes even without one, I can still be appreciative of how certain colors combine, certain details of light, because sometimes that's also our roles as photographers. Not so much snapping away and snapping huge amounts of film or snapping with our phones and digital cameras, but also appreciate the beauty we see with our own eyes. And of course, I can sit here and tell you that I'm also a photographer because I see the importance in documenting, the act of documenting emotion, beauty, pain, and all of the things in life, preserving a memory and documenting the passage of time. And I also like the idea of preserving a memory in documenting the passage of time and how I react to it, what challenges I have faced, and what changes came my way. And recently we've talked about Ansel Adams on a channel, and he famously said, "You don't take a photograph, you make it." And the truth is that he talked about this, and in his perspective, this included visualizing an image. But also, and more importantly, he was talking about intention. And when he talked about intention in his own work, he said that his intention was to, quote, "present through the medium of photography, intuitive observations of the natural world." And that was his intention. And when I first started thinking about my own photography in a more serious level and realizing what I was attracted to as a photographer and what I wasn't, I realized that it was important to have a set intention because this will serve as a compass that will help us navigate through the different projects and processes of our photography and what our photography will face over the course of our paths in life. And looking back at some of my photos here, I was definitely guided by my intention as to the kind of feelings and qualities I want to capture. And definitely two of my favorite images of this set of photographs I captured are the stairs by the sea, which reflects that sort of dreamy quality life can have, and I love capturing that in my work. And the second image, which I, of course, conveniently titled Lonesome, reflects, of course, a lot of the existentialism and loneliness and a dreamlike state. There's something that I find appealing as a photographer, but also relates to my personal identity. And here I of course love the visual balance, the visual harmony, and in the way the trees are framed creates interesting lines that interact with each other. And of course this associated with the presence of the mist brings forward these ideas of existentialism. And I really like that, and I am extremely happy with how these photos turned out to be. Isn't it really annoying when you have to spend hours getting rid of dust or small particle in your photos? Or when you encounter that perfect moment and you find yourself thinking that this photo might not work because it's way too dark? Well, that's probably because you haven't heard of Luminar Neo, which is a really easy to use editing software for photographers of all levels and expertise. Luminar is honestly a very accessible and affordable software that is different because it combines the traditional tools like cropping and mask with artificial intelligence tools like removing backgrounds, removing power lines, and this provides you with opportunities to fix and edit beyond what you thought it could be possible. And the best part is that you can also use this as a plugin to your Lightroom or Photoshop workflow. I've used Luminar Neo to clean and do some post-work of my film photos for this video, but the possibilities are immense. You can substitute and recreate skies with their sky tool. You can relight a photo that's too dark in a matter of seconds, and that's because the artificial intelligence tool identifies lighting on different areas of the photo, and with this tool you can control lighting within an understood three-dimensional space. But you can find out this and much more if you check out Skylum Luminar Neo. The links will be in the description. And so I wanted to thank Skylum Luminar for providing me with this opportunity and sponsoring this segment. And now let's go back to the video. And so all in all, I'm very pleased with obviously this whole experience, these images, these, this body of work that I've been developing over the last, years. And I can see, for instance, that, because I obviously acquired different cameras over time, but didn't focus necessarily on that and focused on my work and developing my voice as a photographer, artist, whatever it is that I can consider myself creative, that it really is paying off. And this is why I created this channel, and I want to always put an emphasis on the thinking and the feeling in photography, because looking at some of these images now in Madeira that I captured, that I can see that there's a line between them and, for instance, like images that I captured in Egypt 2-3 years ago, images that I captured in Blackpool, about a year ago. Now I think that it's so important, this idea of focusing on what we want to say with our photography, why we photograph, and our intentions. And yeah, I'm very pleased and cannot wait until my next travels and where I'm going to go. And obviously there's so much to improve, and I'm looking forward to see what my photography kind of like, how it develops. And obviously very excited for you, so don't forget to write down below why you photograph, what you've been doing, and yeah, I think it'll be cool to kind of like have this dialogue. And I'd like to thank you for watching, for supporting the channel, for everything that you guys have been doing. It's really, really been so positive and so overwhelming, and I cannot thank you enough for that. And I'd like to thank Luminar for sponsoring this video. And don't forget to check their links. It will be in top of the description, and also links to the limited print that I'm going to be doing. So if you'd like to pre-order some, I'll be, it'll help the channel quite a lot. And yeah, I guess that it's been all for today. So I hope to see you here sometime soon. If you have other places that, you'd like to, maybe suggest for me to travel next, let me know as well. And yeah. Stay safe, keep shooting film, subscribe for a cookie, and peace.
Are you going to Scarborough Fair? Parsley, sage, rosemary.